So after sandblasting, the first thing you want to do is clean your walls and remove excess stones, because you want to have some really nice joints that you can grout afterwards. Also try to remove some of the old clay so you get sufficiently deep joints to apply the grout. Let's give it a try. So, once you have taken out the stones and made your joints a little bit bigger, it's time to clean it up. You can use a broom, but it won't take away all the dust particles, so I prefer an air compressor, and that's a bit of a dirty job. So I like to keep a clean workspace, so I do a piece each time. And now I can actually imagine myself grouting, and I can check if there are still some joints that need to be cleaned. Like maybe here, here. Yeah, there's still some pieces to do. But overall, it's starting to look like something. Now up there still needs to be done. I think all in all, it takes a day to clean up one wall like this. The small stones, everything that comes out, I separate them and I keep them ready for future use, because you can use these to fill up large gaps and also maybe to finish up the top. So it's a beautiful winter's day and they promised us another 2, maybe 3. Excellent time to do some grouting. Temperature must be at least 5 degrees. I think we'll get to 10, 12 today. Let's go. doesn't always seem to look the most efficient way, really. There are other ways to get it out there. But I have to carry everything over in buckets to the other side, so... What can you do? And of course, cleaning immediately afterwards, it helps. For the next round. Yeah, there's lots of tools to do grouting. Well, lots, not really. But many people use a plastic grout bag. I did a lot manually previously until a friend of mine found this little baby. And it has become my big friend. Because you just put it in. And it also mixes for you while you apply it to the wall. It's fantastic, really. That's why I kept all the little stones, so I can use them to fill up the big gaps, you know? By the way, this product, Malta Antica, it's not just for aesthetics, although I think it looks much more beautiful than cement. But it's also a product that keeps the walls breathing, which I think is very important. Done. That's another 50 kilos, two bags. Still have about maybe 300 square meters to go inside and out. I tend not to count the number of bags because I will go mad. Anyway, there's a little piece left.
So,
the last step, basically though also the most rewarding one, but it's hard, cleaning out all the joints by hand. You have to take away all the excess lime, and I really like to see the stones, so the joints have to be cleaned really well. Actually beautifying. course, the time it takes depends on how much time you want to spend on it and how much detail you want. And I tend to like it done well. So, and by the way, I always kind of think that, you know, it's a one-time job, so better do it right. Quite a difference. I think it's time for a break. It's probably like 5 o'clock. I'd say glass of wine for sure. It's gonna be a long night. So, still going strong. Beautiful evening. Look outside. Also a nice temperature to work, so sometimes I think, shall I do 2 more bags? That's another 50 kilos. Of course I can do that, but then I tend to forget that I still have to clean it afterwards. So you end up working at night, because if it gets hard, it's more difficult to make it look nice. I guess it's time for another glass of wine, really. So you might think, same evening. Not really, next evening. Same clothes, definitely. That's like a little bit of a ritual. I will put on the same clothes even tomorrow while I have to finish the back wall. And only after that I will give them a good clean up. Hand wash. Soak. Soaked in water. Anyway. So, didn't do too many square meters today. Even though it was a beautiful day, But you know, you have to do these pillars, and these pillars, they are like delicate ladies. They take more time. And then cleaning the joints, you know, sometimes you make a mistake, you have a little bit of a hole here and there. Sometimes a corner gets lost, you have to fix it. It's almost like a relationship. Anyway, this is in fact the second apartment. And I still have to do that little bitsy corner there. And all this wall here, all up there, also not the easiest part. But then tomorrow I hope to finish that monster. Now that is a little bit easier to do, just have to wake up a little early and get maybe 6 bags done by noon. Yeah, I wonder, because Monday, it's Saturday, but Sunday, tomorrow it's already gonna be a little bit colder, and then we're gonna have a big cold front coming for at least a week, so definitely no grouting. I have to finish the walls inside, woodwork, that's always nice. So, back to work, some good music, and it's all right. So, it's Sunday, another how many bags, 200 kilos, and the big question is, are we done or not? Of course we're not done yet, let's see. So the top part needs to be finished everywhere. That will take another 2 or 3 days. I have to select stones, but first of all, I have to put some electrical, flexible electricity conduit, those black cables. And while I was working, I pretty much figured out what to do with lights and electricity. But that needs to be done, but the rest is all done, and I'm a happy guy, really. Of course, tonight, today, there are the pillars that I did yesterday, that wall, I did it yesterday, but now I still have to grate these joints. That will take some time. So all in all, it took me about 2 weeks. Yeah, this was like 7 days, and sometimes it's also good to just stop, do a good cleanup, because next week it's all about woodworks, closing up the walls, adding isolation. And the good part is, clean environment makes me happy. But the best part of all is that, like this, you get to do something different every week, and that keeps it funny. 7 steps, I said. So the first one was sandblasting. I had that done in December. And the second one is scrostare. That's the part where you basically clean the joints, take out the small stones, so you get nice joints which can be grouted afterwards. The third step, that's cleaning the joints, dust, particles, etc. Then there is the grouting itself, step 4. And what I still have to do upstairs this evening, grating. Beautify, to beautify the wall. Oh, it's the most rewarding work, but it's a lot of work. And then there are 2 more steps, but that's for later, maybe in a month or so. You see, I really want those stones to be clean, so I have to polish them. When you grate them with a steel brush, they get pretty clean, but still, there is some residue. And if you do that 6th step, then the last one is basically for maintenance and to keep away the dust. So you apply, it's not a paint, it's something special that I have to call the guy who delivers it to me. But you give a treatment to all the walls, so it doesn't collect any dust and they stay nice for years. Of course, you have to repeat that every so often, and especially in the bathrooms, probably every 2 years. Maintenance, not my strongest point, but I'll get it done. First, a bit of wine. And some good music. They said it was going to be cold, but still, today it's a pretty nice day. I think the cold front is coming tomorrow.